Hey guys, I'm Jacqueline.
And I'm Marcella.
And we just finished watching episode 7 of season 6 of The 100. And you guys, Clark, this episode.
I love this episode so much.
Oh my god.
It was so Clark-centered, and yeah. I just love that. And it really explored, like, how much guilt Clark has and, like, her subconscious and how her subconscious was almost, like, it was, like, attacking her subconscious because
she hasn't fully faced everything.
No.
Like, she's felt that guilt, but I don't think that she really...
And I feel like she holds...
Like, she had to deal with
yeah.
it.
Yeah. Like, she holds on to those memories.
Yeah.
Like, and she holds on to all of the bad things that she's done, like, all of that guilt as, like, a reminder. And,
yeah.
like, she feels like she has to carry that still with her. And, yeah, that was just... I feel like we really explored Clark's mind, and I just love that so
much. No, and I think it was so... What was so great about it is Clark's mind is something that, like, we've never fully gotten to explore in this way. Because, like, we've always seen Clark, like, she'll... She basically kills people, and then, like, yeah, okay, I feel bad about it, you're forgiven, okay,
but she always has to move on.
But she always has to move on quickly to the next thing. So I think that it's really important to remember that these things, they stay with her, and they're not easy. These are not easy decisions that she's had to make in the past. And I think that we saw that earlier on in the season as well when she almost killed herself, like, when it was directed at her internally, like, she has that conflict still, and I really love that we were able to delve into that, and she literally had to face her demons, and every, like, room that she would go in, I love the way this was filmed, like, how she would change outfits, and it would be certain moments, like, key moments from every season, and, like, it was just unbelievable the way that they did this. Like, I loved everything about it. I love that the first person that she saw was her dad. I love that the first person she saw was her dad. Like, her dad was just in that room. And
it was
just
so emotional.
So sad.
It was sad because I think that she, like, she kind of was like, I died. And she thought that, like, she was reunited with her dad. But then she realized, like, that really wasn't the case.
Yeah.
But, yeah, that scene was really, really sad.
I love
that Monty is back. Like, before that, though, we do get Allie.
And then
we get the whole thing with the memory, and that was, like, the memory that she had to hide.
That's the reason why she was able to still be in there, was because of the EMP and all that stuff that happened back in, like, season 3. So,
yeah.
It's interesting that, like, they think, like, wow, like, we never, like, took that out of Clark. We just took out the flame. Like, we didn't take... that out, and that's why it saved her, actually. Like, it ended up saving her, which was so cool and such a twist, because I think everybody thought that it was going to be because she was made into a Nightblood, and that's why, but I like that they kind of did it differently, because everything else we kind of did see coming.
Yeah. So something different.
Yeah, it was cool. I love that the way that they had it where all of her memories were around, like, the ship, and every time, like, you would hear the voices, like, it was just so, like, all, like the detail in this episode was just so well done, and it was just so well written, honestly. Like, I really enjoyed this episode, like, a lot. I think that they did such a great job, like, focusing in on certain moments and giving those moments time. Like, I loved when she saw Octavia and we were back in, like, the arena of season 5, and she just was throwing at her everything about Bellamy. Like, you left Bellamy here.
Yeah.
He thinks that you're a monster and everything. And it's like Bellamy was, like, her weakness. Like, she feels so much guilt for that, and, like, her reaction to that, like, she was, like, crying almost. Like, it was just so emotional, and she's terrified that Bellamy didn't actually forgive her.
Exactly, that's the thing. Like, all of these things, like, her, like all these conversations with these different people, that's Clark's subconscious. It's not actually those people. So what Octavia was saying is what Clark is really feeling, like, deep in, like, her subconscious.
Yeah, she's
so
terrified.
Clark is just so scared that, like, yes, Bellamy forgave her, but there's still that doubt in the back of Clark's mind that, like, what if Bellamy really didn't forgive me, and it's, like, not genuine, and, like, that he thinks that she's a monster. Like, that's something that is, like, bothering Clark, and I feel like it's so important to take a step back and, like, for us to see Clark's mind and, like, really, like, feel what she's feeling, because, like, this show is very fast-paced, and, like, it doesn't really take the time a lot of the time to, like, step back and, like, really reflect on, like, how these things that the characters are doing is, like, affecting them.
Yeah.
So I think that Clark this was like really, really well done, because Clark is somebody that like we need to see that, especially because of how she was thinking about killing herself.
Yeah, I'm so happy that they gave that attention.
That got attention in this episode with Monty, and how Monty essentially really like convinced Clark
to live
and to keep fighting.
Yeah, but before that though, before she was just getting beaten down by her mind, and it was the seeing that memory of Bellamy like making that deal that really pushed Clark to like not want to live. Like it basically, Josephine realized her weakness was her people and Bellamy. Like those were like the two big things for her, and she was basically like, well, you know, Bellamy made a deal and all of your people are gonna live, and if so, you like, come they, out then
that's gonna fuck that up, and like they don't need you to be their savior. Like that's pretty much what it was.
And like I think that's something that terrifies Clark, and that's what made her really not want to live. And seeing that memory of Bellamy, like the way she was like, Bellamy would never do that, like, and then she was like, well, no, Bellamy took your death hard, but he did make a deal, because your people is what's important, right? And I just love that, like, how Clark was like, no, like, he wouldn't do that. Like, she knows that Bellamy would avenge her and figure out what the hell is going on there, and realize that it's not a safe place and all of that. And I just like those moment when she really like breaks down and she gives up and she's crying, and when she gave that memory, you see Jasper's goggles in there, which was good.
Yeah.
And then you see like the video thing of Jake.
There was a lot of detail. It was great.
Yeah, but I when she really breaks down and starts crying, and I think it's also that realization of like she was literally faced with death, where she was given the option, like, yeah, like, you could die, and she does give up that, she gives up briefly, but I think that those tears were also, like, I want to live, and I think that that's what this episode really showed her, and her facing Josephine was literally, like, I want to live, like, I don't want to die, I want to keep going, I want to fight, and I love, like, so many lines about how, like, she's, like, I don't go down easily, like, I'm gonna fight my way out, like, it was so good, and yeah, I really love that realization of, like, no, like, I want to keep going. And Monty coming in and saving her and just giving it was most emotional thing. Because, like, Monty is just one of the good ones. And that's probably why, like, she had Monty in there. Like, it's just, Monty's so good. And
well, because Monty, literally, like, his last words to all of them was, like, do good. And yeah, so the fact that it was fitting that it was Monty who was the one that was there and telling her.
I'm gonna cry again.
It was just so fitting, and I love that it was him.
I loved all of their scenes, like, and, like, their outfits were, like, from the drop ship, like, the jacket, and then her outfit, and then she hugs him, and he's basically, like, you know, like, be the good guys, and then she tells him, like, you know, Bellamy did make a deal, and how I love that Monty was able to help her through that, and he was, like, on her side, like, they held hands, and it was just, like, nice that Clark had her friend there with her. Even Maya, I really liked that scene when they had Maya coming in.
Yeah, Maya came back,
and
too.
I like that when they brought Maya in, they, Clark ended up realizing, like, I can control myself here, like, I can control all of this that I'm seeing, and then she was able to put, like, the collar on her, like, I thought that was really cool. Like, I love seeing Clark fighting back, I thought that was great, but
I know, yeah, even, like, physically, like, they were going at it for a while, too. Yeah, it was really great fight scenes, and that was really cool to watch, and them like running through all the rooms, and like it was just especially when eventually Russell comes in too, and they're both like chasing her.
It was so cool. But I loved that shift of like, we're fighting, we're broken down, but no, we're gonna keep fighting. It was like it was like a process, you know, like it wasn't even like, no, like we have to fight our way out, we gotta get out of here, like, no, like Clark literally got beaten down by all of her demons. She literally had to face her demons. That's, I guess, that's the theme of the season. Yeah. And yeah, just having Monty there and having Monty help her be able to use Morse code to get to Bellamy. Like, those three are, like, working together.
The scene when Bellamy has the notepad and he's looking and he saw Clark tapping
through Josephine.
And then when it said alive, and that, the ending with Bellamy, and he's just like, alive. Like, Clark's alive and we're gonna get her back. And it was just like,
And his face, he was so
happy.
And like, he was like so like heart Bellamy there. He's like, we're getting her back. Yeah. Like, I don't care what, we're getting her back. I can't wait till he tells Maddie too. I'm excited for that. Like,
I hope he goes and tells her soon, because Maddie was not doing well last episode.
Like, I feel like he's gonna tell Maddie.
Like, I wonder if Bellamy's gonna like go straight to everybody now, or if he's gonna kind of like just him and Miller kind of like handle it first. I don't know like what Bellamy's plan is.
I do love that it's Miller and Bellamy, because those two go back from like season one.
Yes.
Like, I love
that. I thought it was a really funny line when Bellamy was like, oh, like Pike, like we like learned Morse code, and Miller was kind of like, I slept.
Like, what you're talking about.
Like, Miller had no idea.
So confused.
That was really funny.
And like Bellamy, like the little nerd that we love so much, is like understanding like this Morse code is coming through. Like, how did you?
He's so smart though. She was literally just like this, and he knew
that was actually Clark sending a message. And it kind of had like a Stranger Things vibe, like the way they used the lights.
Yeah,
with him. Like, right. Yeah, I thought it was really
like the Christmas lights. Yeah.
Yeah, Josephine, though.
I thought it was really interesting when they went into her mind.
Josephine.
She had that really tragic thing happen to her where the guy was like obsessed with her, and then he shot himself right in front of her. And that was the memory that she was hiding, which ultimately was what like Clark used to get like the message across to Bellamy.
The whole stuff with Josephine's mind was really interesting as well. I think that she's somebody that like we have to remember, like she's been around like forever. Like, she's as old as like Allie. Like, she's been around forever. And I just think that
I thought it was interesting that
she has so many lives that she's lived.
Yeah, like when they went into like her that memory that she was hiding, you see the newspaper and it's like Dioza.
Yeah.
And then like it's like the magazine and it's like Allie.
Yeah, I thought it was so cool. And to see like the way that Earth was, like the way that we know Earth, like it's like a coffee shop, you know, like it was just really, really cool. And I am so, so excited for what's gonna happen. Although now Josephine woke up, she told Russell, like, no, Clark is still in there.
But it's okay, because Bellamy knows.
Bellamy knows. I'm very excited for how the hell this is all gonna turn up. I mean, we still got like 6 episodes left, right? We got
13. I know, and I feel like it's starting to pick up really fast. So
we'll see. I'm very excited. Let us know what your favorite scenes were. I think everybody's favorite scene was Bellamy at the end, and then Monty.
I think Monty and Bellamy were the best. This whole episode though was so good. Like, I'm loving this season. This season it's been really, really good. And I think it's just gonna keep getting better.
Yeah. So let's talk about everything down in the comments below. Keep your notifications on. Remember, we're going to be going live this weekend with LM Reactions and Simple Reactions to talk about the episode.
Yes.
And and all of our social media is down in the description box below.
Thank you for watching.
Thanks for watching. Bye.